Doug Lemma, John, who have been manning the table and, you know, having to make Ron and Benini's job easier by keeping the drink station staff coming out in the kitchen, straightening up chairs in here to make, you know, all the staff at the Eagles Lodge. They're all volunteers, a lot of the cooks, they come here just to volunteer because what happens here at the Eagles Lodge supports their efforts. And Bruce running the soundboard and a lot of other stuff just nonstop. And they're all doing it very professionally, taking it very serious. You know, it's not a goof-off kind of thing, and they're you know, really on track with everything. You know, on Thursday when I got here, you know, I was coming about an hour late, and I was surprised I walked in the room. All the chairs were set up, and the mixer board, everything was already set up, and I'm thinking, that didn't really have much to do, and everybody was asking, you know, people were coming to me asking me, can they pitch it in help? I said, well, I don't know what to do, because it's already all set up. So, thank you to all of you, and, you know, to make it possible here, kind of really took a lot of stress off of my mind, and definitely want to thank the Eagles Lodge. You know, they give us such a great deal to come here. You know, John Benini was, you know, trustee for here for a long, long time, and this is kind of like a second home, and so it's kind of tribute to him to keep it going on here. And so, anyway, thank you, Professor Howard.
Thank you.
Does anybody have any comments, questions, suggestions, or any questions for presenters up here? If you do, come up to the mic.
I can share something. When I was putting together this talk, I didn't know how to put it together. I didn't know how all the parts fit together. And I was reading this, and then I was reading that, and then I was reading somebody else, and it's like all disparate things. And they all had to be strung together. And there was just a lot of work that was just put in to do that. And I appreciate all the time that Lauren talked with me when I had a question, or I had something to say to sound off, is this right, is this wrong? And so he would correct me, and I really appreciate it with the extent of his knowledge, particularly with the Tesla stuff. Lauren, thank you.
Yeah, this is my first time here, and I've been researching all different forms of energy for at least 20 plus years. This is a very, very important event for me to have the opportunity to actually talk with so many people here who are so dedicated to doing this work. I've learned an amazing amount, and I love the idea that one of the presenters said of making us some specific open source project that we can actually have real plans and engineering designs to start rolling out for more experimenters to get more quickly connected to being able to do things. Such an amazingly inventive world of people, and yet there are so many subtle things that go into making this technology work that I think that would really help us jumpstart it. So that's my comment, and thank you all so much.
Thank you. I have noticed in my research when I've looked, I like to look at a number of different sources for information and all, and I'll provide some scientific information and religious information sometimes, and channeled information, all kinds of different sources, and I noticed that on the part of some scientists and researchers, there's a reluctance to address those non-scientific sources, and I would appreciate any of you, the panel's input on that, and what that feels like for you folks.
That's not part of the science paradigm. You really have to take in information from all places. Not that it's all correct. And there are some people who have their own way of understanding things because they're thinking out of the box. They have their own connections to upstairs to get ideas and to understand how certain things go together. And it may not be in any published paper. It may be just the things that they say and they pick up and they tell you. And you have to listen very carefully. And if you listen carefully and are receptive, then you open yourself up to do more ideas and to put things together. Because this area, it needs to have both the inventions worked out, it needs to have the theory worked out. And when those two go together, then you actually have the introduction of all of these kind of devices, whether they be free energy or longitudinal wave devices and health devices and so on. All of this comes together. And so it doesn't make a difference, even the education of the person. What's important is that they have some ideas and some connections, and to listen to them, and you pick something up that gives you something. So I think what he said was important, regardless of whether the source is conventional or unconventional.
I think one of the things for me that's been kind of interesting is the hardest thing for me has been to be able to get away from a traditional way. People would say, oh, it can't be done, or this is the way it is, you know, it's just you're just foolish to be thinking about that sort of thing. And I'm pretty susceptible to the way people think of me, and it shouldn't be that way, you know, but that's just my personality. And that's difficult. And so I think what the projects and this kind of thing have taught me is you have to be kind of have a tough skin. Think they'll tell you that it doesn't work, or think it does. And
So if you have spirit